guys, Vaso. This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and it's time to review a fucking classic, Mars vs. the Monorail. So, without further ado, let's begin.
Simpson, Homer Simpson, he's the greatest guy in history. From the town of Springfield, he's about to hit a chestnut tree.
Now this spoof of the Flintstones is fucking awesome and very fucking funny. What the Simpsons is very good at is making parodies that make them funny. And this episode does a great job doing just that. And trust me, that Flintstones parody isn't the only good parody in this episode. I will talk about more of them as the episode continues. Later, Montgomery Burns abuses toxic waste and has to pay $3 million. Now, $3 million is something that most people wouldn't be able to pay. But thankfully for Montgomery Burns, he is a fucking trillionaire. Not only that, he pays $3 million directly from his wallet. So wait a minute, he has that much money in his fucking wallet? Wouldn't it be a better idea to use his fucking credit card? I mean, think of how rich pickpocketers could get by stealing that wallet. But then again, maybe the jury doesn't accept credit cards, so there's that. And then later, there's a town meeting where the citizens of Springfield discuss what to do with the $3 million fucking dollars.
Hello, my name is Mr. Snrub, and I come from someplace far away. Yes, that will do. Anyway, I say we invest that money back in the nuclear plant.
I like the way Snrub thinks.
Montgomery Burns, usually I like you. But now, you're being a fucking moron. I mean, seriously, did you really think that no one was gonna see through your disguise? It was just a fucking mustache, so seeing through your disguise is far too easy. I must admit though, the way you use a grappling hook is fucking awesome. And then Marge Simpson comes up with a suggestion and holy shit, she actually says something intelligent for once. Now let me make something clear, I don't hate Marge at all. In fact, I do like that character, but she still is the dumbest character of the show, and usually what spouts out of her mouth is total bullshit. But not in this episode. In this episode, she is saying something very smart, and you know what? I fucking love her idea. Yeah, broken roads need to be fixed as soon as fucking possible. And now comes a scene that I find incredibly fucking funny. It's when Abraham Simpson is trying to finish a sentence, but every single fucking time he tries, he's interrupted by people cheering before they even hear him out fully. This is so fucking funny, and watching that never gets old. Now everybody likes Marge's idea. Marge gets interrupted when Lyle Lenley sings a song about fucking monorail. And I gotta admit, that song is fucking awesome. Now, a monorail might sound like a good idea on paper. And you know what? It is a fucking awesome idea. So everybody fucking supports that idea. And if I was there, I would too. Now, Homer Simpson wants to become a fucking monorail conductor. Along with many other people. Yeah, all those fucking people want to become conductors as well. But only one of them can become the monorail conductor. The guy who gets to be the monorail conductor It's Homer fucking Simpson! Holy shit! That makes me so fucking happy, especially since Homer Simpson is one of my favorite characters of this show. In fact, he is my second most favorite character of this show, with Montgomery Burns being my favorite. And I wanna see him control that fucking monorail. That would be so cool. But then Marge Simpson discovers a notebook where it's revealed that this whole monorail thing has been a fucking scam. Damn, that was an unexpected twist that I didn't see coming. So that means that Lyle Lanley is the villain of the episode and a fucking con artist. And for a villain of this episode, he is very fucking awesome, I must admit. Now Marge drives far away from town and meets up with a scientist called Sebastian. And he is basically the fucking hero of the episode since he wants to stop the monorail before it's too late.
Now I'd like to turn things over to our Grand Marshal, Mr. Leonard Nimoy.
I'd say this vessel could do at least warp 5.
And let me say, may the Force be with you.
Do you even know who I am?
I think I do.
You all know who that actor is. He is, after all, a very popular Star Trek actor. And you know what makes this scene so fucking funny? It's the fact that the mayor confused Star Trek with fucking Star Wars. And that makes me laugh so much. Anyway, moving on. And then the monorail gets out of control and Homer can't use the brake. Seriously, fuck that cunt Lanley for putting all those people into danger. And to make matters worse, that monorail goes on solar power. So shutting down the electricity won't do a damn motherfucking thing. Is there any hope for this monorail to be stopped? This is indeed very fucking scary. All of those people can die. And they most likely will die. Damn. Thankfully, Homer has a plan that will help stop the monorail once and for all. You see, he uses a fucking anchor. But not exactly. He takes parts of the monorail and uses that as fucking anchors. And that thing that stops the monorail completely is that donut building. And I just gotta say, the fact that Homer was able to stop the monorail, even though it was difficult, is truly fucking awesome. But Homer isn't the biggest hero of this episode. You know who the biggest hero is? It's Marge Simpson, because she is the one who brought the fucking scientist Sebastian Cobb. And using one of the items as a fucking anchor was his idea. Marge Simpson is fucking awesome in this episode. In fact, it's one of the few episodes where Marge is actually smart. So yeah, now it's time for my overall thoughts. This episode is fucking awesome and truly a classic. The best part about the episode is how fucking smart Marge is being in it. And this is definitely one of my favorite episodes focusing on her. So you know what? I'm going to give this episode the rating 2 thumbs up. Well guys, that's all I'm going to say. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.